Hey, it's Natalie here from Canine Concepts, and to kick off day one of Deaf Dog Awareness Week, I wanted to answer some questions that I get asked a lot. Why are some dogs deaf, and why are deaf dogs usually white? Just like in humans, deafness can be acquired at some point in the dog's life, or it can be present from birth, which is known as congenital deafness. Congenital deafness is usually hereditary, which means that the pup inherited the genes responsible for their deafness from their parents. Deafness can occur in just one ear, called unilateral deafness, or the deafness can be bilateral. And to make things even more complicated, deafness can also be partial, where the dog can still hear some types of sounds, or the dog can have profound deafness. The technical term for the type of deafness that my boy Havoc has is profound bilateral pigment-associated cochleosaccular deafness. What? Cochleosaccular deafness is a type of deafness caused by the damage to the cochlea, that snail-shaped organ deep inside the ear canal that allows you and other mammals to hear. To understand what happened to Havoc's cochleae, we need to think back to that high school biology class where we learnt that every structure in every body is made from cells. Your ears are made from millions of cells, your skin is made up of billions of cells, your fingernails, eyeballs, brain and blood vessels are all each made up from millions and millions of individual cells. Because each of those cells is a living thing, they need nutrients to survive. This is where melanin comes in. You may have noticed that lots of deaf dogs are white. This is no coincidence. You see, the pigment melanin not only gives our hair, skin, and eyes their color, it also keeps the perfect balance of nutrients like potassium inside the cells that make up certain blood vessel walls. If those cells that make up those blood vessels get too much or too little potassium, the cells will die and the blood vessel will collapse. This also means that any organs that were supplied by those blood vessels will die too. Because Havoc is white, he doesn't have the pigment melanin in most of his body. Not only does his fur lack pigment, the cells of the blood vessels deep inside his ears lack pigment too. One of those blood vessels lacking pigment is the stria vascularis deep inside the ear. When the puppy is developing, the stria vascularis is supposed to supply the cochlea with nutrients, but for dogs like Havoc, that doesn't happen. Because they've got no melanin, as a newborn puppy, the potassium levels in the stria vascularis cells become fatally out of balance, causing them to die and the blood vessels to collapse. Then, because the cochlea had their blood supply cut off, they die as well. That simple lack of pigment produces a massive domino effect, resulting in pups like Havoc never developing hearing. This all sounds brutal, but it's actually completely painless. The pups don't feel a thing and they don't know any different. For them, not experiencing sound is all they've ever known. If you're enjoying this video so far, consider giving it a thumbs up so this information can spread far and wide. So why does all this happen? There are two genes that increase the risk of deafness in dogs, the extreme white piebald gene and the merle gene. Variants of the piebald gene are responsible for Irish spotting, where the feet and the tips of the tail are white. It's also responsible for white flashing across the chest. Some breeds like Dalmatians, Bull Terriers, Staffies and Boxers can carry a variant called the extreme white piebald gene. Just as the name suggests, it causes a lot of white to appear on the coat, and this in turn increases the pup's chance of being deaf. Fun fact, the extreme white piebald gene is also responsible for the whiteness in the coats of spotty dogs like Dalmatians, as well as other white spotty dogs who have no Dalmatian in them, like Stormy here. You might not believe it, but Stormy is not a Dalmatian, not even a little bit. Rescued by Hear No Evil Deaf Dog Rescue Australia, Stormy is a mix of Staffy, Mastiff and Bull Terrier, with just a sprinkling of Coolie in there too. She's a total character, so if you're looking to adopt, check out her profile in the description below. So what about the merle gene? Well, whiteness and deafness in breeds like Great Danes and Border Collies is usually caused by inheriting two copies of the merle gene. They're called double merles. Aside from deafness, double merles can also have eye disorders ranging from starburst pupils to small eyes or even no eyes. Despite all we know about these genes, very little scientific research has been done on the relationship between genes and deafness. We know that there is an association, but it's not a simple case of all double merles or all extreme white piebalds being deaf. It's much more complicated than that. Chaos here has the extreme white piebald gene, but he's not deaf. At the end of the day, it's really important to remember that deaf dogs are dogs and they still live amazing lives. And training them, well, I'll address that question in the special video that I made for day 2 of Deaf Dog Awareness Week. I'll pop it up here. If you can't see it, that's because I'm still on day 1. Come back and join us again tomorrow. Bye.